Good morning from Israel. This is...
I'm Kate.
Wait, it hasn't
started.
Oh, yes it has.
Alright, try again.
We're here in Israel. And actually, how do you feel about today?
Well, we are currently going to the Garden Tomb to see where Jesus was buried.
Yeah. It's going to be a good day. I'm pretty excited.
Are you ready for this?
Yeah. I'm treating myself.
It's like, people, are you ready to go into the Garden Tomb today?
I am so ready to go to the Garden Tomb. Did you catch me talking about when I was an
like you can move it, but it was actually 3 tons. Fun facts.
Look at the trees, they're really pretty. Kendra, where are we?
We are some quarter on the Via Dolorosa, I think.
So Emily, what did you think? What have you thought about the Via Dolorosa so far?
It's really amazing. It's really cool to see and learn more about it.
Yeah.
Shalom, everyone. We are in the Church of the Holy Sepulchre. Shalom. Shalom, everyone. My name is Ashley, and we are touring the Church of the Holy Sepulchre.
And look, Jesus is super ripped. You see that? Other than the fact, it's like a weird 4-pack.
Shalom, everyone. Ashley here again. We are still in the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, and we are checking out the spot. Crazy.
I got a story for you, Ags. Take it off.
Okay. So there's a classic shower curtain with Jesus on it, right over there. And I don't know about you, but I feel like being naked in front of Jesus might be like a little bit Like, I know we're supposed to be that way, but it's a far cry from the garden.
How are y'all doing?
I'm very tired.
You're very tired?
Yes, but I'm having a blast.
Okay. What is your favorite thing about today been?
Going to the garden.
Did y'all get to go inside the cave in there?
Because there's still a really long line, but
okay, cool.
She went in there.
How do you like this church?
It is very beautiful right here.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And you like all the writing on the walls and stuff?
Indeed. It's very, yeah.
Very, I need a descriptor to go
I'm
with that.
I'm just at a loss.
Wow, speechless. That's crazy.
Kendra and Emily, we are reporting from the Mount of Olives. Day two, we did a lot of holy sites today. We're going to get some end of the day interviews pretty soon. Right now we're just resting before we go to the Overlook. It's been a long day full of a lot of things.
A lot of great things.
A lot of things. Yeah. A lot of holy sites. Yeah. So, expect updates soon.
לאשר בשמיים ובארץ. לחמנו נותן לנו דבר יום ביומו, נסע לנו מסענו, כאשר גם אנחנו נסענו וכיוונו. ואל תביאנו במסך, כי אם תצילנו מן הרשע. אמן.
State your name for the camera.
My name is Clint Boyd.
Clint Boyd, okay. And what was your favorite part of day two in Israel?
Favorite part of day two, this is going to be a tricky one, is actually the people on our bus. It's so interesting to meet the students and hear about their stories and what they're experiencing. That has been surprisingly inspiring. And there's too many things biblically to list that have been inspiring. Sorry, Gethsemane, pretty impressive. Yeah, lots of things.
And what was the weirdest thing you saw today?
Oh man, weirdest thing?
New question for day two.
Nothing comes to mind. I can't frame that.
All right, well, then I'll end the interview there. State your name for the camera.
Hello, my name is Nathan Sanders.
You were in my interview yesterday, so.
I was.
What's your
part two?
Yeah, what's your favorite part of day two in Israel?
Day two? Definitely the garden tomb, I would say.
Same, I cried.
Yeah, it was a very powerfully convicting moment, and I really enjoyed the atmosphere and just how serene it was, and there was a sense of reverence there. And I thought it was really
And they kept sharing the gospel.
Yeah.
I liked that.
Yeah.
What would you say, how would you compare the Church of the Holy Sepulchre to the garden tomb? If it's even comparable.
Yeah, so the comparison is that they both claim to be a possible spot where crucifixion and the burial happened, but they're very different. One is a church that's been built over the site, and the other one is, I guess, a reconstruction of something closer to what it would have looked like in the original time. The other difference is it's a really different atmosphere, church of sepulcher. Really packed.
Yeah.
So,
Christian.
For me, there wasn't the same air of reverence. It felt a little touristy. It's still great. It's a very impressive building. It's a very beautiful building. But I didn't enjoy it as much.
All right. So the reason we stopped that interview show was because of the view. I don't know if you can see it.
pretty lit.
But did you want to take this opportunity to roast David Lee too?
Okay.
Cool, thank you.
Yeah, David's a great guy, but fashion choices. Sure. Have you seen that little star thing you got?
He's wearing.
That's all I have to say.
Oh, you're just getting roasted.
You see for yourself.
Wait, where is he?
Oh. Get him right
I don't know. He's right there. He's taking some pics. Update on David Lee Tate's fashion choices.
Hey!
Camille. And Camille, what was your favorite part of day two in Israel?
I'd say the Mount of Olives. It was a place like I'm just overwhelmed with a sense of peace. And some of the other stuff has been awesome, but just a little overwhelming in a way. And I just found like a sense of peace there, knowing that like Jesus found rest there as well. And it was so cool to just have a time of like prayer, just time in the Word that was awesome, and we weren't surrounded by like thousands of tourists, which is so cool because I love that many people are like wanting to like know about the Lord and where He walked. But yeah, the Mount of Olives is certainly like some place that's so incredibly like peace-giving, and I love that.
And what was the weirdest thing that you saw on day two in Israel?
So in the Church of the Holy Sepulchre, there's a lot of like Byzantine era paintings, and those like depict the human form a little bit differently. They don't really have a lot of depth, but also at the time, they thought of like babies as like just miniature humans, and so there were like pictures of like baby faces, but they were like full-grown faces and like slightly balding, and it was just like right across from where Jesus was supposedly crucified, and I was just a little confused, and I was like, this is a little weird. I was like, I get that they're trying to like honor him the best way that they know how, but I just like I turn a corner and there's just, like a little baby face right there, and I was like, huh. So yeah, I was like, this is a little odd. Catch up with me later.
See you at day three.
Can I get one volunteer to read verse 37?
As he was drawing near, already on the way down the Mount of Olives, the whole multitude of his disciples began to rejoice and praise God with a loud voice for all the mighty works that they had seen.
That's the Mount of Olives. And then in 41 it says, and when he approached, he saw the city and wept over it.
Father God, let the different people that reside within Jerusalem see the similarities that they have and respect each other's differences in a peaceful and in a way that everyone continues to be happy, healthy, and will hopefully see the light that shines down upon them from you.
We pray that you come back soon.
Hello, camel.
One,
two, three,
four,
five,
six, seven.
Louder.
Should we start over?
Let's start at 11 again.
11!
11, 12!
13!
14!
15! 17!
18!
Whoop.
20!
Where's
19? There's a lot to be.
No, this is the one I videoed and it's not going so well.
As sharp as
what was your favorite part of day two in Israel?
It was like a really good reflection to go into communion and you liked it.
My favorite part. Daily wait for the elevator.
Hi. About 10 minutes later, we made it off the Shabbat elevator. No regrets because the other elevators took way longer.
But here we are going to dinner.
We are done. We had another Palestinian perspective speaker come, another one. We had our first Palestinian perspective speaker come speak to us. It was really good conversation, kind of tense environment when one of the girls was kind of sassy with a question, but not one of the A&M girls, another girl from another school. But it was really good. We had some great debrief discussion afterwards to kind of discuss thoughts and feelings and emotions from the first 2 days in Israel. It's been insane, exciting, emotional, and crazy. So it was a fun day. Can't wait to see tomorrow.